So hello students, how are you all? Hope you are studying well. So today I am going to start our second chapter from second term syllabus and its plans around us. Hope you have already seen my first video where I have explained the first chapter and this one is second. So what are the objectives of this chapter? In this chapter we are going to learn the different types of plans, then different parts of plans, then how plans help us and how we should take care of plans. Okay, so now let's start the chapter. Plans are all around us. They give us shade and clean air. So plants are very useful and essential. You all know plants are very essential for us, for our day-to-day life also. Plants give us shades and clean air, fresh air. Now the parts of plants. The different parts of plants are roots, stem, leaves, fruits, flowers, etc. These are the main parts of plants, and some other parts are bud, then branch, then fruit, flowers, etc. Stem, roots. You just look at the picture, this part is called root, this part is called stem, this small part is called branch, this one leaf, this one fruit, this one flower, this one bud. Now all these parts have different function. Now start with this. Functions. Root. First one, root. Root fix a plant to the ground. So the root of the plants fix the plant to the ground. Next one is stem. Stem help a plant to stand straight. That means this part, stem help a plant to stand straight. This may be small, this may be big also or broad. Then most part have broad green lips. They help them to breathe. Like human being, plants also need breathing. So we human being have nose, and with the help of nose we can breathe. Like this, plants need lips for breathing.
Similarly,
plants need lips for breathing. With these lips, a plant can breathe. Now some plants bear fruit, some plants bear flowers also. That means plant gives us fruits and flowers. Another one, seeds are found inside fruits. Seeds later grow into new plants when they get air, water and sunshine. Just like that, we found seeds inside a fruit, and these seeds later become a new plant, or these seeds later grow into a new plant when they get air, water and sunlight. Okay. Now, the types of plants. Types of plants. Some plants are small, some plants are big also. Now big plants. Plants are bigger in size are called trees. That means the plant bigger in size are called tree. They are strong, tall, and trees have thick stem. Like this. Trees have thick stem. Okay. And they are tall and strong also. Like coconut tree, banyan tree, then mango tree. These type of plants have thick stems, strong and tall. Okay, now these are small plants. Look at the picture. Can you name the flower of this plant? Yes, obviously this was rose and this is a small plant. Then plants are smaller. Plants smaller than trees are called shrub. They have thin and woody stems. That means the plants that are smaller than trees are called shrubs, and they have thin and woody stem. Rose, hibiscus, cotton. These are some example of shrubs. You can look at this picture. These are smaller than plants but have thin and woody stems. Now the plants with soft stems are called herbs. Some of them have medicinal value. These are smaller than sharps. Now, the plants that are smaller than sharps and have small stems are called herbs. And some of the herbs have medicinal value. Mint, grass, wheat are the example of herbs. Now, what is the difference between sharps and herbs? Sharps are smaller than tree and herbs are smaller than sharps. And sharps has thin and woody stems where herbs has soft stems. Now, the another kinds of plants are fruit-bearing plants and flower-bearing plants. Fruit-bearing plants, that means the plants which bear fruits. And flower-bearing plants, that means which bear flowers. For example, apple, mango, these are fruit-bearing plants. And gulmohar, plumeria, these are flower-bearing plants. Now, the another kinds of plants are water plants. That means most plants grow on land, but some also grow in water also. Do you have know this? We all know this, that most of the plants grow on land, but some plants grow in water also, like lotus, water, hyacinth. This type of plants grow in water also. Now, most important things, how plant help us. Plants are very essential things or very useful things for us. Plants help us in many ways, like that they give us clean air to breathe. So we human beings need oxygen for breathing, and plants provide us this oxygen. Okay, and plants also make the air clean or fresh air. Now we get fruits and vegetables from plants. Plants provide food for animals also. Okay, you all know this. We get different fruits, vegetables from plants. They give us flowers also. They give us shades also. It means plants provide us shades, fresh air. Now, plants give us wood. It is used to make furniture such as chair, table, bed, etc. Now, at our home, we can see different types of furniture like bed, chair, table, almirah, etc. etc. And these are made of wood. And these woods we get from plant. So, in this way, plants are very useful for us, and plants help us in many ways. Now, taking care of plants. As plants are very useful, so it's our responsibility to take care of plants or take good care of plants. So, we should plant more of them. We should plant more trees, or we should not cut trees. Okay, water them regularly. As plants need water, so we should water them regularly. Keep the plants outside so that they can get enough sunshine. So plants need sunshine also to grow up. So we need to keep a plants outside the house so that they can get enough sunshine. Not pluck their flowers or leaves. Try to not pluck their flowers and leaves of the plants. So students, hope you will understand this chapter. Okay, let's
end it here.
And this is all for today. Okay, thank you.